On this lesson, I'll be doing some questions from different prelim exams. So I'll be focusing mostly on Euclidean geometry. I hope this will be helpful to everyone who's writing their prelims. So without wasting any time, I'm going to go straight to the first question. So the first question, we're given circles, and of course we need to spot the different theorems which will be present on the given question. So it will be very important to spot all the theorems which are there. So we're given a tangent which is going from A to C there. So all you know, if this a tangent, for example, if I have a tangent like that, and then we know that this probably, let's say we've got a triangle that forms there. So we already know that the angle that will be forming, I'm just trying to erase this, my drawing is just not accurate. So we already know that if we're having a tangent line, the line that forms, or the angle that forms outside your tangent, that angle that forms there, we know it's going to be equal to that side, the one that forms there. So in other words, without even wasting any time, I already know that whatever happens, E1 will be equal to angle B, because that's Tancourt theorem, based on what you know about Tancourt theorem. So we already know that E1 will be equal to B. Just put it somewhere on there. E1 must be equal to angle B. No? So E1 will be equal to angle A1 will be equal to angle B. And angle B, we already know, is given to us as 32 degrees. So that would be Tancourt. No? So the reason for that is Tancourt. So that's Tancourt. So already we know for the first question, they want us to find E1. So E1 will be 32 degrees because of Tancourt theorem. No? So that was a spot, a way question to spot, that's Tancourt theorem. And then therefore E1 is equal to 32 degrees. That will be the first one there based on Tancourt theorem. So we continue now, and then they're asking us to find angle F. So angle F, we need to also go and check, where is angle F? Angle F is there. So we have got angle F in that triangle there. So angle F is on that triangle there. That's angle F there. So we have angle F is forming part of EFB. So angle F is forming a part of EFB. So in other words, we've got EFB that is being formed like that. That's EFB being formed like that. And then this one is F here. This angle here is F. This one is E1. I would have E1. Yeah, that's E1. And then this one will be B1. So we're forming that triangle. That will be our F there. And then that will be E. E is there. Then that is B. No? So that's our triangle E. FB. That's forming. They want us to find F. E1, I know, is 32 degrees. No? So we can put E1 as 32 degrees. And on that, oh yeah, we can see that E1 and B1, their angle on opposite sides. Né? So their angles which are equal, because they are angles opposite sides. So they're going to be equal to each other. So meaning, in other words, E1 should be equal to B1, because those are angle on equal sides. So E1 would be equal to B1. Their angles which are opposite of each other. So angles which are opposite of each other are equal. So they're always equal. So angles which are opposite of each other are equal. So they're going to perform equal sides. So angles which are opposite of each other are equal. So E1 and B1 will be the same value because angles opposite each other are equal to each other. So meaning, in other words, B1 is also 31 degrees. So 32 degrees. So meaning B1 is same as the other one. So meaning now I've got two values. So that means that now we've got E1 and also B1. So B1 you also have, that's 32 degrees. So meaning, remember, it's a triangle. Sum of a triangle must end up to 180. So we already have E1. So we know that E1 and then also B1 and also angle F. When you add those three angles, because an angle just put there, when you add those three angles, they must add up to 1/8 because of a sum of a triangle. Now, so when you add those three triangles, they should add up to, so those three angles in a triangle should add up to sum of triangle, so they should add up to 1/8. So I mean, in other words, those three of them, when you add them, they should add up to 180 degrees because of sum of triangle. So now we know what E1 and B1 are. They're all 32, they're also 32, and then plus then F there, and then the whole thing will be equals to 180. Now, so from there onwards, to find F, just do the values as they are, and then I'll just minus them. So I'm going to add the first two, 32 degrees plus 32 degrees, that will be 64 degrees. So meaning F will be 180 minus 64. 180 minus 64, that will be F. 180 minus 64, 180 minus 64, that will be 116 degrees. So F will be 116 degrees, because when you add A1, B1, and F, should add up to 180. So F will be 116 degrees. That's for F there. And then let's just try to erase to get space now, because I want to find also angle D. Now they're asking us to find angle D, so we need to spot where angle D is. Before you do anything, to spot where angle D is, oh, that's angle D there, at there, that's angle D there. So we know about angle D being there. And then do we have a cyclic quad? E D F B. Yeah, they're forming a cyclic quad. So E and then D and then F and B are forming a cyclic quad, and we know about opposite sides of a cyclic quad. So meaning F and what do you call it? F and D, they are opposite sides of a cyclic quad, and we know that opposite sides of a cyclic quad must add up to 1/8, or they're supplementary to each other. So meaning angle F there that we have plus angle D, that should add up to angle D should add up to 1/8, because they are opposite sides of a cyclic quad. They should add up to 180 degrees, because the reason would be that they are opposite sides of cyclic quad. The opposite sides of a cyclic quad, the opposite not sides, opposite angles of cyclic quad, the opposite angles of cyclic quad, not sides, opposite angles of cyclic quad. Of cyclic, that would be cyclic quad. Cyclic, just call it cyclic quad. Cyclic quad. So that would be that. So meaning angle D will be 180 minus F. So angle D will be 180 minus F, because we need to find D now. So 180 minus angle F, and then we know angle F was 116. So therefore, angle D will be 180 minus 116. 180 minus 116, that will give us 64. So meaning angle D is 64 degrees. That's angle D. So let's quickly also look for the next question. Let me just erase this so that I can have space now. I already know what angle F was, 116. Angle D we know is 64. And then B1 we knew it was 32 degrees. And also, yeah, so we've got all those values now. Just need to go and add everything together. We need to go and add everything together and see what we can get. Okay, so from there onwards, they want us to find angle O1. So we need to spot where angle O1 is. That's 8.4 there. So we need to spot what angle O1 is. Okay, O1 is there. So we can already see that O1, that's O1 that is there. It's that angle that is formed there. And O1, we can see that it's a center. O1 is a center. O1 is a center. So we can see that O1 there is the center of circumference D. And we know that angle at the center is 2 times the circumference. So meaning O1 is the center of D. So O1 will be 2 times 2 times angle D, because we know angle in the center, angle D, angle at center is always 2 times the angle at circumference. Angle center, that will be the reason. Angle center is 2 times angle at circumference. That's what we know about circumference. Just call it circumference. So that would be that. So meaning O1 will be 2 times of what D is. So D was 64. So meaning it will be 2 times 64. Then meaning O1 will be 128. So meaning O1 will be 128 degrees. That would be O1. That's 128 degrees. So that would be our O1. So lastly, we are left with E2. So we need to also go and find where E2 is. Now, where are you, E2? E2 is this one here. That one that is there. That's our E2 there. Do you have any other angles which are linked to E2 then which you can use? Oh yes, we have got this other second triangle now. So our second triangle is this one, which is like that. We've got E2 there, and then we've got O1 that we just found now, and then we've got B2 then. So that's another triangle that we know that we have. So same thing applies. We've got that's E2 then, and that's O1 there. Then of course we've got B2, that's this triangle there, the second one that is there. We know again that same thing will apply like the previous one that we did. Angle E2 plus angle O1 plus angle B2, angle B2. So when you add those three triangles, because we have a triangle, they should add up to 180 based on the sum of a triangle. So all three of them should add up to 180 degrees. And then the reason is that that's the sum of a triangle. It's the sum of a triangle, because three angles to a triangle should add up to 180. That would be sum of a triangle. So that would be that. So, and again, same thing applies. E2 and B2 are equal to each other. Their angle, which are opposite, meaning they're equal. So again, E2 will be equal to B2. Those are angles opposite, and then opposite sides. So angles opposite sides are equal to each other. Angle opposite sides, they are equal to each other. So angle opposite sides are equal to each other. So meaning they want us to find E2. The aim is to find E2 now. So I'm just trying to put it here. The aim is to find E2. So meaning E2 and B2 are equal to each other. So meaning E2, where you see B2, just put E2 again, because they're equal to each other. So it'll be O1 there, and then plus B2 and E2 are equal to each other. Meaning instead of writing B2, we're gonna put E2 now, and the whole thing will be equals to 180. So just to put E2 as that. So we've got the two like terms of E2. So it'll be 2E2 will be equals to 180 minus O1. 180 minus O1. So let me just add this here on top. So meaning our 2E2 there will be equals to 180 minus O1, which we know O1 was 128 there. So it'll be 180 minus 128. That would be that. So then 2E2 will be equals to 180 minus 128. 180 minus 128, and that's 52. That'll be 52. So let's put the degrees there, guys. I don't know why I always remove the degrees. That'll be degrees, also degrees now, and then angle there, then angle, then angle, then angle, then angle. So now we've got 52. So remember, the aim is to find E2. So to find E2, we just divide everything by 2, also by 2. So meaning lastly, our E2 just come back as like X, and then we know that the answer will be 52 divided by 2, which will be 26 degrees. So meaning also B2 also will be equals to 26 degrees. Then they didn't ask us for B2, but also B2 will be the same, because the angle equal opposite of each other. So that will be that with this question, and I hope it was very helpful to you guys. And then if something doesn't make sense, please comment on the comment section. And then yeah, that'll be all. Thank you.